Howdy folks, Troy with V-Twins to V8s, coming on to do a short video about a problem we're having with the sniper system on the 51 Ford project. My customer's been using it, he loves it. After the transmission, he's just been having a ball, lighting tires up everywhere, but it developed a low fuel pressure situation. And it's something that other people are having. Other people also have high fuel pressure. So what we're going to do is we're going to talk about how we can fix these things. So let's get to it. Okay, so the scenario is the truck was running great after I did the transmission on it, and he had it for a couple of weeks. Everything was fine. He calls me up one morning and says, "Hey, my truck's running like crap. I've only got 23 PSI on my fuel pressure gauge." And I'm like, ooh. So my first thought was, hey, maybe you picked up something in the fuel. Maybe you got a clogged fuel filter. You know, always start with the easy stuff first. So we changed the fuel filter, and voila, it started running. But it still didn't have quite enough fuel pressure. It was at about, he said maybe about 53, but he said it was running pretty decent. I said, all right. I said, well, you know, drive it around, see what happens. Maybe it'll clear itself out or whatever. So then he calls me a few days later and he says, I barely made it home after I went to a car show, did a huge burnout, and then after that, it just never ran right after that, and he said, I barely made it home. So he fired it up the next morning to bring it to me, and he thought he was going to have to trailer it, but it turned out it cleared itself up to the point where he could at least drive it. He lives quite a ways away. So he drives it here, and so the first thing that I do is I start looking for, you know, potential problems. First, I verify the fuel pressure. He brings me the fuel filter that he took off of the vehicle. So what I did was I cut that open and looked inside of it. There's nothing in that fuel filter. It's perfect. So I'm like, okay, we've got the Holley in the tank fuel pump. So I'm thinking maybe there's an obstruction or something in there. So yesterday, I took the fuel tank down and I tested the fuel pump pressure right at the actual fuel pump. Got more than enough pressure. So then I wanted to eliminate any restrictions in the line, so I took the new fuel filter that he put in there, I took that out, I blew through the line, the feed line, and then I took the return off and I blew through the return. That's all clear. So now I'm trying to think about, all right, so what is going to be the problem? It's got to be something that's within the fuel regulation. So I did a little homework and I found some guys online that were talking about having problems with this fuel pressure regulator that goes in the back of the unit. So this is the fuel pressure regulator that goes in the sniper unit. This cover here bolts on the back of this here, depending upon which way you want it to go, like that, and then inside of there goes this fuel pressure regulator. And people were talking about having problems with this screen right here on it being clogged, things of that nature. So I'm like, all right. So I had the sniper unit still bolted on, and I decided I would try and take this apart. So I took the cover off, that was no problem, and I tried to pull this out, because all it does is set in there with this little rubber O-ring. And I'm reaching back there, and I'm like this, I'm pulling on it, I'm trying to get the thing off, and this back cap, I actually pulled it off. I'm like, that can't be good. And then when this thing came in two pieces, I couldn't get the other piece out of the unit. So I ended up unbolting my sniper unit here so that I could turn it and have a look at it. And what I ended up seeing was what you see inside of here. This area inside of here was all covered with the powder coat that should be on the outside of the unit only. It was in here, and it was starting to degrade from the fuel, and pieces of it were missing, pieces of it were gone, and that's what was holding my little thing from coming out. So as I started messing around with it, I scraped all of the stuff that I could get at here, and then I was able to remove this. And then after I got that out of there, I scraped all the stuff out of here so it was nice and clean. Now that I have that clean, I'm going to put this back together, and I'm going to replace this unit here. I ordered a new one from Holley, and it's going to take a couple days for it to come in. Okay, so why is this thing so important? So what it's doing is it's restricting the fuel at a constant level to keep the inlet fuel pressure at 58 psi. So it's regulating, because it's a fuel pressure regulator, right? I saw some other videos from some guys that took and used a fuel pressure regulator, like a boost style regulator, like we have on the firewall, to regulate the fuel. So my question is, can I just eliminate this, add an adjustable regulator, and eliminate any future problems from this? Or should I run this and go back to where I want? And I'm going to try it both ways, because I don't have a lot of confidence in this now, because it almost left my guy on the side of the road. I'd rather have something on there that's free-flowing, that can be adjusted at any point in time. The other thing is, like, that the adjustable regulator coming out, I can get that dialed in and it's going to stay right there, and I can adjust it 1 degree up, I mean 1 PSI up or down. I can really, really dial it in. This here is predetermined, so it's either going to work or it's not. The other thing that I heard was people were installing new regulators and pushing on this back in the center to push this thing into the location. And when they did that, it bends this cover, and then they have high fuel pressure because this is restricting it. So why would this be making high pressure or low pressure? Pretty easy. Low pressure if it's stuck open. High pressure if it's stuck closed or has a restriction. Because remember, all the fuel pressure is regulated by a restriction on the outlet of the return line. So I don't know whether I'm going to use this or not, but it belongs with the unit, so I figured I'd order it. I'll order the other one, and I want my customer to have a vehicle that we can dial in and micro-tune it, and he doesn't have any problems. You know, we all work hard, we all do whatever we want to do. On the weekend, you want to go out and play with your toy. You don't want a broken toy. You didn't want a broken toy when you were 5 years old. You don't want a broken toy when you're 50 years old, that's for damn sure. I know I don't. So that's what we're going to work on, and I'm going to put it back together, and we'll kind of go through the process, and I'll show you the remedies. Okay, so I'm back here on the project. What I did was I wanted to make sure that everything in that throttle body, that powder coat that was in there, was completely flushed out. So what I did was I connected a piece of 6AN line without the regulator in there, and I attached a hose to the end of it, and ran that to a can and cycled the key a few times and let the fuel pump flush the entire throttle body. So once I did that, I took and I put a cap on the end of the return line fitting to, in essence, just block it, just make it so nothing came out. So then I turned my key on and went to my prime, and voila, got more than enough pressure. So once I figured that out, I said, well, I got nothing to lose. I have a pressure regulator that I use that crimps off the return during the boost process, because you need rapid increase in fuel pressure. So I said, I wonder if the regulator that I already have on the firewall will work to maintain my fuel pressure. And voila, it does. I'm gonna take the small camera, I'll show you the setup I have, and then we'll fire this up. Okay, so here is my throttle body. Here is where my regulator goes inside this housing. I left this regulator out. This is where my return line connects on. This is the cap that I put on there to block it off. Now I have no regulator in here. I have my line coming off of here, and it comes around, comes into this regulator here, and then goes out, and this sets your idle fuel pressure. This vacuum line, or what, if you want to call it vacuum, it does go to the intake manifold, but with a supercharger, it will be under pressure, is going to increase my fuel pressure when I go under a boost condition. you're going to have a volume of fuel going to this unit so that when it comes under wide open throttle or high boost, you can have that, have all the fuel you need. What was happening before I put this regulator on that has the vacuum outlet on it, the boost regulator, when I went into boost, I was going lean. So we can't be having that. So his remedy for it was to set it up like this, like what I just showed you on the handheld, so that this will regulate the fuel pressure, and when you whack it and it really sucks the fuel, which it will, when it comes under boost, you have the volume of fuel you need. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna fire it up. Okay, so there you go. Now you can see it does run pretty good. The fuel pressure is right in the zone. We got excellent throttle response. I'm gonna drive this and see how it behaves. Okay, folks, so the truck runs awesome. So the takeaway from this is if you're experiencing high fuel pressure or low fuel pressure, I mean, other than the obvious things, low fuel pressure could be a restriction in your uptake, in other words, at the fuel pump or at a fuel filter or in a line. High fuel pressure is more than likely going to be at your regulator or a restriction in your return line. So, you know, start off, check the basics, but that pretty much sums it up in a nutshell. I appreciate you guys tuning in. If I can help you in any way regarding pretty much anything automotive, feel free to leave me a message. I'll respond to your messages in a pretty timely manner. I check my messages every day. I appreciate you tuning in. Please like the video and subscribe, and good luck on your project.